today we have got together here as a curtain raiser for the forthcoming event of the Haifa Day on 23rd of September. This is the 100th anniversary of the Battle of Haifa, which took place on the 23rd of September 1918 in the north of Israel. So we may ask, what is the relevance of this battle for us here sitting in India, of a battle fought so far away in the northern part of Israel, in the port city of Haifa? I will just like to share an experience that I had. I was to lead the Indian contingent to Israel for a visit from the National Defense College. So the Israeli embassy hosted a dinner for the team which was going there, and at the end of the meal, the ambassador of Israel in India, he gave a speech. Normally they are quite informal people, but he decided to give a formal speech at the end of the dinner. And the commandant of NDC was also going, and I was along with the team. And the commandant told me that you will reply, give the return speech. I was least prepared. But then I knew a story which was told to me by one Brigadier Jodha, who's now retired, whose grandfather had taken place, had taken part in the Battle of Haifa. And when I met him in Jodhpur in 2011, he was doing research into the subject. So I had come to know about this battle from him, the grandson of a person who had taken part as part of the Jodhpur Lancers. So I had not prepared a return speech to the ambassador. So I gave a speech. I told him, have you all seen the Teen Murti circle? So they all said yes. So I asked, do you know that there is a connection of the Teen Murti circle with your country, Israel? So including the ambassador and all the embassy members present at that dinner, they said, no, you're sitting at the table. Then I told them the connection, that the Teen Murtis, or the three statues in the Teen Murti circle, represent three cavalry regiments, the Jodhpur Lancers, the Mysore Lancers, and the Hyderabad Lancers, who were part of the 15th Indian Imperial Brigade, Cavalry Brigade, which was part of a cavalry division, 5th Cavalry Division, commanded by a Britisher called Major General Allenby. And I said, this cavalry brigade, the Indian Cavalry Brigade, liberated Haifa from the Ottoman Turks and the Germans and the Austrians, who were fighting against the Allied forces in the First World War. And so I told them that every time you as an Israeli cross the Teen Murti circle, please salute those soldiers who liberated that city of yours long ago. And then we went to Israel. There I was amazed when the people told me, the people of Israel, the people of Haifa told me that every year we lay a wreath, the people of Haifa, they lay a wreath at the Haifa Memorial, and one part of it is called Hindu Memorial for the Indians. And every year the people of Haifa on 23rd of September, for the last 100 years, they lay a wreath to remember the Indians who liberated their town. And they showed me photographs, old photographs, of Indian cavalrymen having retaken the city of Haifa from the Ottoman Turks and the Germans and the Austrians. The Indian cavalry riding through in a victory parade through the Haifa town. So while the people of Israel were doing this, in India, except for Jaipur, where every year there is a Haifa Day and some kind of a celebration is carried out by 61 cavalry, in whose grounds we are sitting now, and this building where you are is called Cavalry Retreat. Every year, 61 cavalry, which is the modern version, which has emerged after all the cavalry forces were merged into one. The Jodhpur Lancers, Mysore Lancers, and the Hyderabad Lancers, and several others, were all amalgamated into 61 cavalry. And it was the vision of the first Prime Minister to say that we need to have a bridge between the past, that is horse cavalry, and the present. Horse cavalry has now become tank. The tank regiments represent what was earlier on the horse cavalry. So, because the first Prime Minister decided so, 61 cavalry still exists to remind us of our past. This year is the 100th anniversary. This place, Haifa, is a port city on the Mediterranean coast, on the western coast of Israel. About 30 kilometers southeast of Haifa, there is a plain area called Megiddo. In Greek, when Greeks were ruling the place, it was called Armageddon. And Armageddon, as you know, in the Bible and in the Quran, is the place jahan pe kayamat ka aakhri ladai hoga. You know what is kayamat? Kayamat is judgment day in both these religions. So kayamat ka aakhri ladai, when God will judge all the people and all that, will happen in Armageddon. That is why the word Armageddon is equivalent to the final battle, the ultimate battle. And historically, many battles have taken place in this area because it goes through a pass, a mountain pass, and gives access to the coast, Mediterranean coast. And that is exactly why the Battle of Haifa also took place, to get a link from the east of Israel through Jordan and coming on and getting an outlet into the Mediterranean Sea, which further gives access to Greece and to Europe. And the Ottomans, Turks, had been ruling for about 400 years. And the city of Haifa was held by them for 200 years. And this battle was fought principally to save Jerusalem, which is holy for both Muslims and Christians, to prevent the Ottoman Turks from heading towards Jerusalem. That is what the battle was all about. Now, what is the relevance of Indians there? We were ruled by the British. They took these forces there all the way from India, the horses and the men and the equipment. And what were they armed with? They were armed with swords and lances or spears. And the Germans and the Ottoman Turks, they were positioned with machine guns, artillery, on very strategic positions. In broad daylight, this brigade consisting of the Hyderabad Lancers, the Jodhpur Lancers, and the Mysore Lancers launched an offensive, launched an attack in broad daylight with swords and with spears or lances, and defeated the Ottoman Turks, the Germans, and the Austrians. 1,350 Turks, Germans, and Austrians were taken as prisoners. 30 of the enemy were killed. Only 8 of our forces died. About 30 of ours were injured. 60 horses were died, and about 65 horses were injured. Just imagine a cavalry force with only swords and lances against machine guns and artillery guns carrying out an attack in broad daylight. So this is the story, and the attack was led by Major Dalpat Singh, who was a military cross from the Jodhpur Lancers, and two of his squadron commanders, Captain Anoop Singh, and the second one's name I forget. And thereafter, the attack was only to capture a hill, but they continued the attack, and both Mysore Lancers and Jodhpur Lancers went into Haifa town, drove out all the enemy, and Haifa town was liberated. This is the story that we are celebrating on 23rd. And for this momentous occasion, we are expecting the Chief of the Army Staff to grace Jaipur to celebrate this event. You will also be aware that last year, our Prime Minister had visited Israel, and he paid his respects and laid a wreath at the Haifa Memorial to the Indians who died for the liberation of Haifa. And thereafter, in a combined ceremony with the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, the Teen Murti Circle was renamed as the Teen Murti Haifa Chowk. I wrote to that ambassador again and told him what I told you in 2012 has now been formalized in 2016, 4 years later. And when I told them about the Teen Murti Circle, the Israelis were there in that dinner. Israelis are normally quite informal people. They all came and hugged me. Though hugging is quite normal in India today, but people more towards that side don't hug. And they were so overcome with emotion that they all hugged me as if to thank me for what the Indians did. There was also an outcome of this. This was one of the first occasions in the First World War when Indian men were led by Indian officers. Otherwise, invariably, in the British Indian Army, the officer lot used to be British. This was the first occasion when Indian officers led Indian men into a dangerous battle and won and liberated a city. Immediately after that, the Sandhurst, which is the British military academy, was opened to Indians. A special commissioning for Indian officers called King's Commission Indian Officers, KCIO, was started. The Royal Indian Military College, then now Rashtriya Indian Military College, was started after that, and thereafter the Indian Military Academy also started. Because the ruling power here accepted that Indians are capable of battling themselves, their officers are capable of leading their own men and winning battle in a most disadvantageous situation, far away from their country, for another cause. So wherever they may have died, wherever they may have fought, Indian heroism, Indian bravery, Indian chivalry have been displayed in this battle. And that is what we are celebrating after 100 years of Haifa. So connected with this, we will be having a great inauguration of a Haifa Memorial near the public road outside 61st Cavalry. You would have seen it as you came in. There will be a classical mounted parade which the Chief of the Army Staff will review. And then there will be some celebrations with the soldiers of 61st Cavalry. This, in a nutshell, is all about Haifa Day.